boy, this is an awkward shitstorm.
It's a little awkward because we're back with our friend here, Jack Choice.
No.
Well, oh, no, it's Alan Wake.
Alan Wake.
Yeah.
Much better name than Jack Choice.
No, Jack Choice, I like it better than
Alan Wake. All right, you want to start a new game, Matt, or just want to skip to an episode?
You know, let's start a new game.
All right, let's do it.
Hey, everyone. After 5 years of everyone saying play Alan Wake.
Stephen King once wrote.
So the reason why.
Why is that, Patrick?
This game is awkward to play for the shitstorm.
Yeah.
It's because we already did this 2 years ago.
For the shitstorm.
And now I have to very publicly admit that I forgot to hit the record button in Audacity when we did that. So we recorded this fantastic 48-minute long Alan Wake video that no longer exists.
Yeah.
Or actually never existed in the first place.
That's embarrassing because I never make mistakes like
never.
That.
Remember back when...
No, let me finish. I never make stupid mistakes like that.
Yeah.
I always record everything. It was wild and then those recordings get corrupted or are useless in a different
there
way.
There was a Machinima episode, I forget what it was, but you straight up deleted it right after we finished it.
What, was it not the original Machinima Catherine?
I think it was Catherine.
Anyway.
Like, for some reason, your brain just completely failed you, and you just went, oh yeah, okay, we're done with this.
Really?
Time to delete it.
You emptied the recycling box, too? I sure did. Anyway, fuck all that shit. Let's play Alan Wake.
Let's play spooky Stephen King stuff.
And you're playing you bumped up the PC version as to the max it can probably safely
play. Yeah, I have a 980 Ti, and I tried to kick it to 4K, and the game was like, nah.
Alan Wake starts talking about, there's this type of reality called the 4Ks. My mind can't wrap itself around because Remedy didn't even know such a resolution existed.
Alan Wake is like downsampling reality.
Yeah. And you know, the other thing that gets downsampled is the quality of everyone's facial animation in Alan Wake, because it's pretty goofy most times.
Oh, you know what didn't get downsampled? The quality of the Verizon ad.
Oh, and the Duracell.
Oh, man.
I was in shock from the crash. I could hardly stand my feet.
You could. Look, he stumbled a little
bit. You know what did not have this amazing style of narration?
What did not?
Like fucking the Jack Choice game,
Quantum Break. Well,
it had TV video movies.
To be fair, it's like you have three games in a row.
You know what? I might actually replay this whole game like as soon as we're done.
Well, you should play Alan Wake's American Nightmare.
It looks really good, and I never beat the DLCs.
I never. Oh, I did.
Yeah.
But I never played American Nightmare.
But
American Males.
But like, it's hard to describe, and I wish more horror-themed games would spend the time. But just moving around and turning the camera
and looking at your tweed jacket
feels fucking great.
Oh no,
oh,
it's
no,
Shadow Man.
Uh-oh, and he's got some kind
Turok.
Of weapon. Get out of here,
oh,
Turok.
Oh, I forgot that he zoomed in like that.
I do not. I think you're God. I gotta get out of here.
So, like, yeah, but this style of narration is like, you know, Prince of Persia games, well, not all of them do it, but some of them do it, where he's telling the story to you, but it's like that and this, and I can't think of anything else.
Oh,
maybe
yeah.
Searching for Ethan Carter. I think maybe the main character, spoke like that.
Man, so, I'm in like genuine awe at how good the game looks.
It really, yeah. What, this came
like,
out what, 2008?
Well, this is a 360 game.
Yes.
Right?
It came out in 2008,
and,
I think.
Good for, oh.
Yeah, the dodge is a lot stricter than you probably remember.
Yeah, a lot stricter. Back when I had good reflexes. There,
what?
Good work.
That was
a good dodge.
Hey, so we talked about this on another shitstorm, but I do not like... I mean, in Alan Wake, it's not as egregious, but, like, I do not like enemies that talk shit.
Mad shit.
And just kind of are like, assholes. Like, it'd be creepier if they didn't talk that much or they said very few things, but every single person just yells all the shit.
I'm lucky.
Life. I work at an auto body shop. Everyone just sounds like an angry Vince McMahon.
But, yeah, I'm shocked how good this... Because all, like, the art design and, the look of the forest and the fog, they put a lot of work into that.
Oh, yeah, when the forest goes nuts.
And all you have
cool.
to do is kick up the fucking res, and all of a sudden it looks like a current-gen game.
Yeah.
Look at that! Look at that!
I don't remember the background being as wavy as that. Hurry! When you get closer...
probably because we only play it on 360.
Yeah.
Hey, what up, bro?
Ah, this is that guy.
a guy who gets fucked hard.
Yeah. Yeah. The other thing about Alan Wake is that this mountain range is ridiculous in real life. There's no mountain range that
could ever be this big.
Yeah.
Mountains, they're small.
Look at this guy. Wait, was he supposed to be a high school student or not?
I think he's supposed to be an old guy in a high school student.
Hey, remember? I used to be in school.
No! So, like,
was this not rated mature?
Oh, it was rated mature, for sure.
I don't even remember a whole lot of violence happening. I remember always there being camera cutaways and shit. There was no way out. Yeah, there's some weird things going on where stuff is getting wavy. Look at the door.
Yeah.
That your thing? Like, it kind of...
Yeah, that's an added effect that that's probably just in the PC version.
Okay, is that or is that not Sam Lake's eye?
That is not Sam Lake. That is like the live-action guy they got to play Alan Wake.
Okay, yeah, you're totally right.
Yeah. You gotta get to the live...
Tom the Poet. Hey, so remember we showed this section to Wooly and he was super unimpressed?
Yeah.
He was like, yeah, whatever, horror. I
could do better.
Yeah.
Yeah.
Like, all that shit
horror's an emotion.
All that shit we talk about, Willie's all in good fun, but I'm actually like, he's always downplaying horror. It's like, oh, it's cheap and lame. I'm like, it sure is.
Well, the thing is Wooly lived in a place in which monsters were real.
Real.
So
machete men were around every corner.
Like,
so why would
we're a bunch of fucking pussy ass little suburban white kids from Canada.
Yeah.
He told me a story about, like, a dog at a junkyard that, like, broke through a chain chasing after them.
Mm-hmm.
That's as close as you're gonna get to a real-life monster.
Cujo.
Yeah, and yeah. It was a mad dog.
So that was my favorite character in the game.
This guy?
Yeah, that guy.
Zane? Zane's fucking great. Goes like this. Close second being the piece of shit dickbag agent.
All that you forget his name because he's called Agent.
I forgot, but like at the end of the game, he's like, "Light beats these motherfuckers." Okay, I got a flare gun and I'm strapped with Christmas lights.
Yeah,
come at me, losers.
That was kind of funny.
And you're like, "That's a super good idea, actually." I really wish they had kept going with Alan Wake instead of fucking Quantum Break.
Yeah, but I don't mind taking a break and then doing it. I don't mind waiting.
You don't mind
a
taking
time.
A quantum break?
I don't mind taking that. I don't mind taking a really long span of time.
Like 15 fucking years?
And to make the open world game we should have gotten,
oh,
yes.
Oh, dude, that game would be impossible.
Yeah, not that I dislike this game, I love it, but like I would have always rather that open world first design that they had for this. Where it was basically deadly.
I forgot how hard this tutorial was. And I don't mean like difficult. I mean like look at the guy with the button. Like it's super intense how tutorializing it is. And he's gonna be like, oh, you ran out of shit.
Yeah, but it's not as bad as like other, you know, tutorials that really break immersion. At least a guy is telling you to do this in a narrative context.
The fact, man, what a genius move to, like, have your crosshair be the goddamn flashlight.
But it's like, yeah, no, for sure. That's, that, what he just said there is a lot like when movie Picard says, you know, kill those people that are still undergoing the board process. They can't be saved.
Fucking kill them.
What about 12 people that did?
What about you?
Yeah, exactly.
We don't have time to save them like we save me. I'm a captain. I'm more important.
Look at my bald head. The lighthouse was the last safe
place on Earth. So, like, this is all that remains of the original version of this game.
Yeah.
Like, and that's crazy to me.
Well, the section where you have to go all the way down to the gas station is quite big, and that also makes me feel that that's where another chunk of open worldness was.
Yeah.
Did you take damage from the fall there?
No, he hit me.
Oh, yeah, you're okay.
Yeah, I'm a huge badass.
Yeah, you're Alan Wake. Look at the fucking patches on your elbows. And everyone talks shit about that. Remember the fucking cop later
on? Omar, you've ruined two perfectly good jackets now.
No, you ruined a perfectly good jacket. Correction, Alan Wake.
I ruined two
perfectly good jackets.
Uh-oh. Whoa, get out of here.
Do you have any other more batteries?
Okay, no, I used them all up.
Oh, yeah, like... Wait, you can still...
Yeah, it still works.
It still works, it's just...
And it regenerates.
Yeah, that's true. I forgot about that. Because they knew that there was no way to really do it the entire way.
Yeah.
With just...
Open this. What am I going to get?
Flare guns. I've always had a problem with the flare gun in this game.
What? Really?
I've accidentally shot it so many times.
Oh, that's your problem. Okay.
Yeah.
Because the flare gun in this game is like...
fucking awesome.
Is the most satisfying rocket launcher style weapon I've ever used.
Look at that!
Look at that fucking baller shit!
So, now try, like, put on your, like, aim right now. So, does it stick onto the flare gun after you've shot it once?
Yeah, of course.
See, I always assumed it was like a one hit thing.
No,
but when you get more than one ammo shot,
it's a special
you
weapon.
Stick to it again. But like fights happen fast and furious.
Oh, so, I accidentally threw him off the cliff.
Yeah.
Well.
So you don't get his loot.
I'm out of here.
Yeah. Good.
I bet there's a thermos up there. The fucking thermoses may be, like, one of the worst collectibles ever.
Because
they do nothing.
They do. They're getting achievement.
They are achievement trash.
Yeah. Because thermoses, you need those for your coffee because you're a writer.
Well, actually, it was about you need it so that you don't fall asleep because the game's about insomnia.
Well,
no, wait, it's not about insomnia anymore.
Yeah, also because you're a writer. I think there's some bit of dialogue that says, I need coffee to keep me up because I need to write. Even though...
There it is.
You haven't written a book in like 5 years.
There it is.
There it is.
The shit collectible. I did it. Hey, what's up? Oh, that looks super
awesome.
Good. Oh, the fucking animation on it goes to 30 frames.
Yeah, but it should. Because it's a weird supernatural tornado.
It gets a pass.
It gets a pass. Don't worry about that. It is kind of jarring where they cut to these little scenes, though, because they do feel
not
like
as jarring
really...
as Shadow Mordor PS3.
Not as jarring as that.
No. That's the real Shitstorm game. We should have waited. Like that on the 31st. Oh man, that's such cool.
Yeah.
Light aesthetic. And you know why they did this FMV, because they wanted that shot, but they're like, no hardware on Earth can render that shit right now.
Yeah, fair enough.
Like, even my PC would probably, like, choke a little bit on it. What? So do you remember the Fallout 4 or 5 episode miniseries they put out like right before the game?
Yeah, yeah.
It was really good.
But the small amount of time you get with her is just like, I never cared about saving his wife.
Did you didn't play Fallout 4 by yourself, did you?
No.
Okay, so Fallout 4 has this problem times a fucking billion.
Yeah,
because
you have to save your wife.
Because no, it's your baby.
Yeah, yeah, your baby.
It's a fucking infant that has nothing. Like, all you need for characterization...
Look how good this fucking water looks!
It looks real, real good still.
Hey,
that looks real good.
Talk to the dude.
Yeah? Hey, where's the dude at?
Right behind you.
Where,
behind you.
Behind me right now? Before he missed a shot. Magical. Hey, what up, dude? Hey. Oh, I can't talk to you. Alright.
Yeah, you can talk to him at a point.
Yeah. The fuck was I talking about? Yeah, and it's like, all you need is one good moment. Right?
Yeah.
I'm posing for you, you dumb bastard.
No, you have to press the pose button. Oh, you're supposed to pose by Stan Lee over here.
Oh, yeah. Hey, Stan.
Hello there. You picked a good time to visit our town.
Oh, fucking Deerfest! Rhymes with Beerfest!
Fucking sick-ass Deerfest. These two look like Half-Life 2 heads. They look very specifically like their heads are from Half-Life 2.
No, I totally see what you mean.
I want to zoom in on your deer head.
Oh, this is the guy that runs the night show on the radio too.
Yeah, the one that bizarrely tangles into Max Payne and all that shit.
Yeah, yeah. Radio station. Any
chance I could get an interview? No.
I came here on vacation, man. You can't do this to me when I'm up at the very top of the power tower, wet with a towel, and then you say, hey, are you Alan Wake?
I came here to cheat on my wife with hot coffee waitresses. What the hell is... Man, why is everyone in Twin Peaks so attractive? Is that Leroy Jenkins?
Not everyone.
Is that Leroy Jenkins?
L. Jenkins's what?
Smoked Fish
Corporation. I don't know.
It does say L. Jenkins.
But and Jenkins does seem like a podunk.
Finding out
town
that Leroy
thing.
Jenkins was a fake hurt my soul. Very nice. I got a couple of really apparently good that, that account is just Need like a fucking friend. Nightmare Best spam bot you. Now.
Oh.
Yeah.
Yeah, is it Barry? Is his
Barry.
Name Barry?
Barry.
Barry. Yeah!
Barry!
Barry, my best piece of shit.
Oh my god.
What do you think of this manuscript?
To be fair, Barry's all both Barry and his wife are like, fucking right.
Fucking right a thing. God.
Now, like, I've written a couple of things here and there in my day, and then writer's block is totally a real thing.
Oh, yeah.
But, like, at the same time, when you're... Just write schlock. It doesn't have to... You can
that's
have some...
That's why LP'er's block is not so much of a thing.
Yeah, we can just force
it. Because the differential between quality and garbage is low.
Like, we started Dark and Sky. We made a video out of that.
Yeah, you made one.
And whether it was good or bad is up to everyone's, but it's bad.
Yeah,
you know?
It's not a good video.
See, this is what I mean. Like,
you all watched
the
it.
The lighting and art style, not art style, but the lighting kind of changes.
Is that a mystery box?
Yes.
Yeah. And yeah, the lighting changes dramatically.
Carl Stuckey.
I'll go fill her up while you get the key. I'll pick you up here in, say, 15 minutes.
Sure.
And this game was, I'm... Oh.
I do like the scene where you're back in the Alan, past in New York with her.
Man.
I love you too. Go on.
It's been a while since I sat down with a game and had a feeling like there's a couple games every generation that you sit down and you were really excited for it and you start to play it and you're maybe, what are we, 20 minutes in?
Yeah.
And you're just like, oh my god, it's as good as I thought. It's as good as I thought. Oh, I'm so excited. Right? And I had that with this.
Okay.
And it's been a while since I played a game like that, and I can't quite remember what it is.
But I'd say, you know, everyone makes that open face in this game, and it looks terrible.
It's 360 face.
Ooh.
Where you make it 360 and then walk away.
You do recall, though, that I remember towards the end of this game going, okay, I get it. Where you were still just shooting the same mobs of bad guys.
I really, really like the shooting in this game.
Oh, it's
so
great, but you're like after a while, you're not gaining anything.
If you get to the end of this game and you're starting to feel, oh man, these guys are awesome.
The best fucking James Hetfield.
If you get to the end of the game and you're feeling like it's a little like, I don't know, I'm kind of losing it.
Game long in the tooth.
Look up the achievements. Because in the last level, there's an achievement for beating the entire thing without firing your gun once.
It's impossible.
It is super not impossible.
Well, how do you attack enemies? Because some things only...
The final level where you get in the car.
Oh, the final level.
Yeah,
sorry.
The one where you get in a car and you drive and drive and drive and drive. That level... is super wide open and you do not have to fire a gun a whole time.
Sure, you're right.
But you can use flashbangs during that achievement.
That doesn't count.
Dude, that is a blast. It is so much fun. It changes it into what I think the game was supposed to actually be.
Yeah, I could see that.
Back in the day.
But the remedy, so they have to have good gunplay.
Yeah. Well, luckily it does.
Hello.
There's a bit where you're like climbing the mountain,
right?
In the second third of the game, before you hit like a water treatment plant, that's like really samey.
This bitch Carl couldn't make it. Unfortunately,
he was taken ill. Hey, look, it's Katrina. Instructions on how to get to the
lake. Here's instructions on how to get to Boyle Heights.
Sure, is Katrina deaf? I'll come
by later. To no.
Okay. Are you sure?
She should lick Alan Wake.
Yeah, lick Alan Wake now. I insist. Do it.
Thanks.
No, I'm telling you, Matt, Katrina's super hot.
Yeah, no, we believe you, Vampiro.
No, man. No, I wouldn't mind getting killed by her. Yeah, you would, Vampiro.
In the dick, though.
No, man. There's a log lady.
Thank you. Oh, you see that LOD?
Yeah.
There's something that's really endearing to me about, like, former rock stars, like, asleep at a diner when they're super old.
Because you're of the opinion that rock stars should die when they're, like, 30.
If that.
Yeah.
Kurt Cobain is a legend forever. They wandered off from his clinic. Because he didn't have time to get shitty. Look at what happened to Steve Tyler.
Bye, Mr. Wake.
Look what happened to his face.
He inspired Itagaki.
Who's the guy with Axl Rose? Look what happened with Axl Rose.
Hey, shut up. He's going to sue us.
Is he?
Because of the picture.
Oh, yeah.
We're talking about how he's shitty. Wait, I was just shitting in the bathroom.
Mrs. Wake! Your keys!
Man, it looks like he just got reamed.
Yeah. Yeah.
He's like, whoa.
Something came up from the toilet and reamed me. Phew. I love this town.
I hate Bright Falls.
This would make a wonderful setting for a book.
We're supposed to be on vacation.
Shut up, Alice!
I'll figure it out when we get back.
At the same time, though, Alan's like a massive piece of shit.
I never doubt that.
Like, because you're like, oh, the Barry and her are nagging about him for a book. And it's like, motherfucker, write a book. And every time someone's like, hey, maybe you should write us something, he's like, shut up! Well, I'm on vacation, idiot!
The thing here is that, like, it's supposed to be a writer. Like, it's like basically saying, like, oh, you can't perform sex, or you can't do the thing that you're good at and everyone expects you to do.
Yeah.
So you take it as a huge offense, and you're just like, no, I can do it, okay?
I can perform writing sex the best!
Yeah, I can perform this hentai fan fiction.
My pen is so big!
My pen is so big.
My penis so big. Only works with that accent.
Yeah.
That joke completely fails.
This camera zoom in. Diver's aisle.
Wow. It's gorgeous.
It's actually really spooky.
If I ever found a place like this,
I'd burn it down.
I would run and then burn it down.
Yeah. From a far away distance. I then started to take a light jog.
So, with the lights on before sunset. This is the part where the initial premise starts to totally fail for me, because if your wife has this phobia, this fucking hyper intense, like,
not
manic phobia,
it's not a passing dislike, it's
no
a
she
manic
starts
phobia.
To freak the fuck out. How is cabin in the fucking woods an acceptable location for vacation? Cause, like, guess what? It's not actually dark in this house.
It's really not.
It's darker in my house
right now.
On average, right? Because I keep a dark house. I don't like the light.
Yeah, he hates it.
Basically. Well, ginger burns.
Right.
Ginger burns. Wait, isn't it out back? I remember you get to skip a bunch of this.
The generator is out back. Yeah. You can play that Night Springs shit.
I can.
Not Night Springs, but
yeah.
Oh, it's The Deerfest guests have already started to arrive. And this is where he fucking tells everyone that Alan Wake's here. We'll see if we can rope him into
an interview later on. Now let's. Well, he doesn't say it's Alan Wake, but he's like there's a famous artist in the town.
Go search for him. He's at Bird Lake Cabin.
Diver's thing. Oh, you mean cabin that doesn't exist?
Yeah, that's true. It's super outside. Yeah. But if you want to look for anything.
The aggressive feel of the nightmare I had seen on the ferry returned.
Look at this creepy photo.
Well, that was evil.
Damn. Damn.
So I don't know if it's a bug or anything, but I just lost 5 batteries by doing that. Power running
in the cabin. Huh?
I had 5 batteries when I started this level.
Maybe the Katrina takes away your batteries.
Yeah.
If you like give her an opportunity to.
All lighting effects in this game are fucking amazing.
And you can find that log with the carving in it.
Yeah.
Yeah, I know. We're doing it, Alice.
I'm doing it.
Is that it right there?
Yeah, it's a power shed. Oh, no. Yeah, this is where I trust my generator to be. This is all that protects my wife from her horrifying, crippling fear.
Yeah.
This ancient piece of shit.
I like this because at least it gives you a mini tutorial on how to make those generators
which
work
becomes very important.
Yeah, exactly.
Very important.
Yeah, but there's that log that's got, like, an etching, I think, of Zane or whatever in this girl. I think, I can't remember if it's that one or another one. Sure thing.
Have fun. Oh, yeah.
Oh, and now we go to nighttime.
It was a beautiful place.
It's true. I did not want to write a book.
This is the kind of place where it to exist. Like, okay. Native Americans find this lake.
Yes.
It is a lake with a small 100 by 100 foot fucking island.
Yes.
Dead center in the middle of the lake.
It's
surrounded by a caldera of mountains.
Yeah.
That shit's cursed. That shit is cursed. It is so cursed.
What are we gonna call that island? We're gonna call it Cursed Island.
Stay away from this, you dumb white people island. Would be that again. All right, fine. Build a cabin on it, idiots.
Yeah, for white people.
Yeah. We fucking told you.
They love curses.
They don't listen.
Now, the virus that's inside the lake, it seeps up and it infects everyone.
Oh, you bastard.
In a certain radius.
I'm so glad we've recorded like half the shitstorms already so that the whole fucking Surprise. Thing doesn't get infected with this stupid joke. This stupid joke is super good. So, is the implication
maybe
here...
Maybe this will inspire you to write.
Is it like, maybe if there's sex, you'll write a book?
Maybe I should use sex as a reward for you to write a book.
Isn't that manipulative and evil?
Oh, he hates it.
No, it's not like that.
And she wants him to go see a shrink.
Hey, was... Okay, she's pretending like she couldn't see him, even though she could clearly see him. God damn it. Also, is that Satan?
It was.
I needed some time. Also, that's really fucked up of you, Alan.
Yeah, that is. Hey, fortunately, her crippling phobia will cause her not to nag me.
That's like, fuck this. I'm going to have to spend some alone time. I'm going to trap you in the house by putting a bunch of spiders on the door.
Yeah. That's fucked. So this...
I'm well awake.
Alice?
I do like that it at least shows a strained relationship that it's like, yeah, they're trying to be like, hey, it's fun vacation. No!
Go to work and do your job, idiot.
Yeah.
All the lights were out.
Does she even work?
She works on the graphic design of his book.
Oh, covers. Yeah, so she also has no job if he has it. It's like, listen, Alan, your job also gives me a job. See, look, now I have five again.
That is weird.
Eat shit, birds.
Sorry, honey, I'm fighting birds outside.
Birds made of evil?
I'm fighting all these Jontrons.
Oh, yeah. I get it now.
Alice?
You know what's a tough one?
What's a tough one?
There's a really specific distinction between cries of fear and cries of I'm about to fucking die right now. And that's like, you know, like when people hear a baby crying, you can tell when it's whining. But there's this baby cry that's like, uh-oh, I better actually check on something, even if it's not my baby, because that sounds like a baby's being eaten by Wolverine.
It's a distinct sound.
That lady totally did the correct one, which was the I'm about to fucking die scream.
Felt like I had woken from one nightmare.
So this is the demo area, right?
I never played the demo.
I think it is.
It makes sense.
Or I think I remember seeing this get shown off. I can't remember. It's too long ago.
It was a while ago.
Doesn't it feel weird to look back on the 360 era and be like, oh, those good old days?
Times were simpler.
Before the free-to-play.
Among Alice's things was a book.
Oh, yeah, this fuck.
Hey, look at this fuck.
The Creator's Dilemma, huh?
Seeing the book brought back
Emil Hartman.
Alice.
Not as cool as his brother, Phil.
And I didn't like the guy's face on the cover, either.
What
were those wires? Electrical wires.
Electrical wires from me flying off the side.
Best bet. They'd have a phone I could use.
I remember starting like the game and just being blown away because this is one of the biggest first levels. This thing is fucking huge. Because you're like, oh, wow, I got lucky.
You have to physically go down.
So you're like, hey, look, it's over there, right? And it's like that entire forest you have to get through.
And right above that is the throat of the world. You can go all the way there.
You can get all the way to the top of the throat of the world.
Oh, no, my rental.
Well, that's that.
Wait, you can look down at it, I think.
Yeah, you must look down at it.
I think. I thought you got some dialogue or something.
Car's fucked.
Yeah, car's fucked, I guess. You're stuck.
My stupid phone was going off. It distracted me.
Good.
There's nothing very Alan Wake thing to do.
There's nothing to get distracted here yet, though. Just spooky forest and stuff.
This looks so good. This looks so good.
That's the other thing with the Remedy games is that we'll take our fucking time, but
Max Payne looked good for like 18 years.
Yeah. Max Payne 2 looked like way, way better like at the time.
I don't like the new design for Max Payne 2.
You don't or you do?
He doesn't look as much like Sam Lake.
No, he doesn't.
And I don't like that as much.
No.
So, Max Payne... Alan Wake has one kind of gigantic design problem that I hate.
Yeah?
And that is, on replay of levels, the notes that you picked up are no longer there because you picked them up as collectibles, but they are a core part of each level's story progression.
Yeah, I know, I know.
Like, being able to read... Yeah, so, like, for example... I think I got all these at some point.
It was impossible to focus.
Right? But, like...
It was impossible to focus.
It's just like, fuck, you know?
Yeah, it's just like, fuck.
The Taken. That's what they're called.
The Taken. What's the name of the fucking group in Omicron that I was like, oh, it's the exact same type of generic.
Oh, I don't know.
The fucking Accursed or The Awakened.
The Awakened.
Oh, that's the fucking best.
My favorite. What's your favorite manuscript page in the game?
I don't remember a lot offhand, but I think the description of a guy with the chainsaw coming through the little cabin that you're in, and then it happens.
I think my favorite one. I think it's out. I think it's when you get out of the jail cell.
All
the
way down.
You find one that is. You know that dickhead PI.
Yep.
Okay, so you find one of him finding a page. And the page is of him reading the page.
That's a good one. That's a good one, too.
And he starts to freak out. And then he tries to, like... I think he tries to do something, but it's on the page. Please. And it fails because it's on the... And, like, he just starts to freaking lose it.
Yeah.
And that's... Like, I remember, like, getting to the end of the game and being like, what is that guy's deal? Because he's never really brought up. And I figured it, like, I guess the deal is that he found that and hates it. He can't handle that, like...
It's always satisfying when the person that impedes progress in a story, like a PI, FBI, something like that, then they either get on board or get killed. It's always the best.
Yeah.
So Stucky has a few good moments here.
Yeah, Stucky's great. Oh yeah, that blur effect looks
super good.
Get
that collectible!
Gotta get it.
I think the lighting and like everything kind of flowing the wind and shit always looks
good. I
got
it, man.
Good fights before me.
Yeah, I got it.
Good.
Oh yeah, that distortion effect is like amazing. This is where he starts talking about his sick deals.
Yeah, that's what I'm talking about.
Yeah.
Like, everyone's the Joker.
Yeah.
Shit.
I gotta get out of here to this super safe place.
I don't care about Stucky's deals.
It is taking, like, game design 101 to the nth degree. Like, characters, people associate light with safety, like, subconsciously. So make all the safe locations these completely fucking blown out with light, bloomed out to shit areas.
He talked about this before, but he just referenced Nicholson and The Shining.
Yeah.
Which, like, Stephen King famously hates.
Yeah, he hates it.
He hates the Stanley Kubrick.
Boy, movie. I hate The Shining.
He loves the TV movie version, which I still highly recommend someone try to track down if they're interested, because it's pretty good, that version. Not that I dislike the Nicholson one.
Yes.
I'm using the phone.
Okay, never mind. I correct myself earlier. This is the section that's really, really impressive.
Yeah.
From a visual and technical standpoint.
Oh, totally.
And Wooly was like,
especially for the era.
And Wooly was like, eh. Because
right. You're like, what's going on? And you're
I
like,
just
oh.
I saw someone run off. Did you see that?
Yeah, I saw that. That's that was weird. Bucky. Yeah, and then Bucky this starts to happen. And you're like... You're like fucking oh, and you're like oh shit,
fuck.
And all the physics items are going nuts.
Yeah,
and you're like oh, what do I do? And
you gotta
then,
do it.
And then I believe like the
just jump out.
Oh,
oh god, you fucking that was clutch.
And then that falls
you
down.
That wouldn't even killed you.
Yeah, I'm a huge badass.
Might have broken your leg.
Oh man, the blur is super intense. Jeez. All right, let's get out of here.
Where you at, Stucky? Thank you,
Stucky. I'll stuck you, motherfucker. Oh, hey, what up?
There's more accursed.
You don't
Why
like
are you
that,
guys
huh?
so cursed?
The feeling of shooting the gun in this game is...
It's a loud pop.
For a handgun, it feels like shockingly good.
What do you get? You get a handgun, you get a shotgun. Isn't there
you get
a
the flare gun.
Flare gun. Was it? You don't get a rifle, right?
You do get a rifle, I think.
Okay, I think that's it.
And then you do this.
Then you get the chain gun, and then the cerebral bore.
I love this mechanic.
Oh, yeah, yeah, yeah.
Because you're like, oh, what the? Oh, what? Oh!
Gotta follow this piss trail.
Oh, the piss.
It's the only weapon that can fight the accursed.
It's piss. My piss.
It was revealed by my flashlight. Someone had hidden a chest of supplies near it.
Cool supplies.
You get a fucking...
Oh, there's like...
Beast flare
there's
gun.
There's granola bars. There's some sippy cups.
I can go... Hey, man. Sippy cups are good.
Yeah. There's bags of Capri Sun.
Just like my underwear in here.
Hey, so, when I was in Florida, they had special limited edition Capri Sun Ninja Turtle...
Shut up.
...ones. It was just regular, like, fruit punch. And I was like, I want the Raphael pack, thank you.
Yeah, you do.
So I got the Raphael pack, and I had a Capri Sun. It was really good. You know what's really good? Mixing vodka with that Raphael Capri Sun.
So this is the part of the game right here where he throws that. I think he always throws that at you.
Can you shoot them out of the air? Like,
I'm not sure, but I was like, this is a little bit like Resident Evil 4 right here. Good inspiration.
No one's going to begrudge you.
Remember when
that.
Dead Space 1 came out and people were like, this is an RE4 ripoff? And the response was, fuck yeah, it is.
Yeah.
That's the best.
You know what's kind of weird is, like, aside from Gears and maybe a couple of shooters, but most of them took inspiration from Gears or whatever. but it's kind of like Souls games where there's some ripoffs, certainly, but not nearly as many as I'd want.
Yeah, I would love for more Souls ripoffs.
Good
it's
ones.
A fucking cool fucking
but
idea.
Like, but like RE4, like aside from maybe, I don't know, Cold Fear, there wasn't that many survival horror-y games that use that camera angle. Or if I'm thinking of them, I can't remember.
Mm-hmm. Well, Gears of War is the big ripoff.
Now, I think I've talked about this before, but like, not a phobia per se, but I think like a super scary way to die is not in an ocean, but falling into a lake at night is like super scary to me.
Well, that is.
I would rather not die in that fashion.
You know what's the worst way to die? To drown in like a foot of water at like a mall fountain.
Yeah, because it's
embarrassing.
It's embarrassing and it hurts.
Everyone's like, whew.
I'm not gonna.
All you could have done was sit
sales.
Up. That's all you had to do.
Yeah,
just sit up a little bit,
but
just a little. Even
I didn't want to tell them that. That's what.
So
they
I'm pretty
had to
sure
do.
There's a manuscript page here that I got.
There's definitely something. Yeah, I remember something there.
Like years ago, because it saved my Steam cloud or whatever.
I saw the.
And look, there's the. You can just see the little baby inkling.
This will be old by the time this goes up. But
very
like,
old.
I saw the new Blair Witch movie.
Yeah.
And it presents a scenario that someone doesn't die in, but it's close to it, where it's like, oh, that's really rough to die there.
Oh, that's a bad one.
Yeah, yeah, yeah.
Is it crawling through a hole in a mountain?
It is crawling through
I
a hole.
I knew it. Barry Wheeler. I fucking knew it.
Barry Wheeler. On a plane after his...
Usually... That's one of the worst ways to go. That's the whole fucking premise of Amagara Fall.
There's also that other movie called The Descent, where, remember that's where... Where the trope of
how do I get across this? I completely forget.
It's I've never gotten mixed up here, and then upon replays I have. There you go.
I remember like blowing through it the first time, and then
exactly.
Yeah, there we go.
Then The Descent, they have the trope of monsters that are humanoid that have lived in the underground forever and therefore cannot see, but can hear everything. They look like weird golems, basically.
That's right.
And it's like four or five women spelunking in a cave and getting trapped in like the most smallest amount of space ever. Real claustrophobic camera work and shit like that.
Uh-oh.
Ow! An axe!
Ow!
The axe tore through my flesh as Matt threw it as hard as he could. That guy has an axe and like a fucking Bowie knife.
So I remember the auto aim in this game being really generous, and I was right. It is very generous.
The ease of this auto.
So like
aim
you
is
see where the beam points.
Yeah.
Anything within like 10 feet of that, in any direction.
Go to supply depot.
Yeah. What a great fucking collectible thing. What a fucking.
Yeah, that's more of
what a app
than anything else.
That's way better.
I failed the jump on the ladder the initial time, but I gained my resolve and tried again.
I hope my wife is dead.
I won't have to write my book.
Oh, I hate writing. I was tricked into becoming a writer.
Yeah.
The tag and are filled with darkness.
Really? These shadow monsters?
Oh, I forgot. That's the part where, this is the part where if you didn't pick up the manuscript where he's like, oh, that's what they're called.
Mm.
And he's like, oh, that's nice. I have a name for the monsters.
Ah, the Torch Foundation. I'm glad they left these Duracell batteries.
I remember that in normal, anyway, in the normal difficulty, that if you scrounge, you get, like, you're drowning in fucking materials.
If you get everything.
And, like, yeah, and, like, the it's not like a survival horror game. It's like an action game. And you know what? That's fine. I would love more action games that take this kind of tone.
Well, I mean, for, like, survival purposes, they're not even health items. There's just, like, going into the light heals you. Right?
I actually really like the health system in this game.
I do, too, but, I mean, it's not very...
It's not regenerating health.
The staircase was broken. I had to make my way up.
It is regenerating health, but it's based on, like...
Progression instead of whatever. Are there health items? I can't even remember.
I don't think so. If there is, I totally forgot about them. Because I'm trying to think of
I think it's Energizer or is it Duracell? I forget.
It's Duracell.
It's Duracell because it's like
because they never stop.
Really blatantly Duracell.
There was no power.
Damn.
There was bound to be a generator somewhere at the logging.
You got
to
get the generators. I think there's just like a green light somewhere. I think down like right ahead of you. There's like a green generator.
Oh, I can see it right now.
There, the way back.
Wow, you're
there.
Super smart.
I'm just because I played through this not too long ago, like I don't know, a year ago.
It's a good goddamn game.
It is.
Uh-oh. Oh. The poop. This is where... Oh!
My head! It's a good thing the handle hit me. And there's dudes with fucking, like, chain sickles and shit. No, yeah, if you do the dodge perfectly, you get the cool shit. Come on, put in your James Hetfield batteries.
Oh! Bitch. Oh no!
You gotta get this stinky oil darkness off them. They hate it.
So, I'm almost about to die. But I'm not. Because you ain't got nothing. What are you gonna do? Come at me. Come at me, bro. Huh?
Be careful. Oh, that was close.
I missed the first shot to make the drama go up.
Yeah, no, you. I was like, I tend to miss this shot. The entire time.
Yeah.
To up the tension in an artificial way.
I failed on purpose.
So yeah, go in the light and let's see if that's how it works.
Yeah, no, that is how it works. You gain health the instant you hit a light source. Because the game's dark. Health!
Ah, the soothing light on my... caressing my asshole.
The whole thing.
I heard them.
Wake got attacked by birds. Oh, fuck. Birds.
Yeah.
They're horrible.
They're one of mankind's biggest mistakes. Yes.
This is how you know a game's good.
It gives you the shotgun within like 30 minutes of playing.
No, I'm going to use the shotgun like pretty soon. And the reason why you can tell a game's good is that the dude I'm going to hit with that shotgun is going to get fucking wrecked.
To make you feel the power of the shotgun.
That's correct. All right, now I think what do I have to do? I did the thing, and then I have to climb.
Turn on that, and you have to use the crane to make a bridge.
Yeah. Whoops.
Make a bridge built with pain. Send my longing down the drain.
I feel like sections like this are super weird and superfluous.
Kind of. I think I remember like maybe there being three sections like this.
Like
this being one of them.
Do I really need to like move it myself?
I hire someone?
Is that really vital?
Well, it's to get past this area because I think it's like it's all blocked off with logs. But then how do these guys get through this area? Maybe something broke or whatever? I don't know.
I did it.
It'd be a really weird workplace to just have to move that every time you needed to leave.
100% of the time.
Yeah, go there.
Alan, can you move your big log? Yeah. I can move my big log.
See what they got to say.
Well, I was just outside for a breath of fresh air.
So this is I really liked because it showed me that I wasn't in some kind of nightmare dimension.
Yeah.
It's just like, oh no, this town is just shit.
Not like that stupid radio guy in Downpour. Remember that?
Oh,
the black
fuck.
Dude?
Oh, that.
Yo, I'm DJ Silent Hill.
I got killed for no reason.
I'm playing all your number one hits like from the Red Pyramid Head.
Fucking help me get out of here.
Oh, wait, he wasn't in Downpour.
And fucking Way of Memories is Shadow Book of Memories. Oh, God, kill me now.
I'm the only one. I hate that game, and I'm the only one that remembers what it's actually called. You said it, but you did it all out of order.
Gas station
say
was
it again.
Closer now.
Book of Memories.
Book of Memories. Good job.
I refuse to accept that game's existence.
Well, you don't need to.
And it makes me really pissed that it's Way Forward that made it.
Yeah, but Tom Hewlett forced them.
He was like, you're going to do it. And they're like, we don't want to with Mr. Tom Hewlett. He was like, you're going to do it.
I actually think that's how it went down.
Yeah.
You're going to do this. No, but
no,
we're going
to... I don't want to.
It's not going to be
He's
good.
He's like, oh, you don't understand. Silent Hill needs to die. Oh, hey, what's up, Froze?
That was in our one of our Silent Hill Did You Know Gamings, but it was like Renegade Kids. Like, they're demented.
You see that?
Yeah, I did.
Oh, look how good that feels. Look how good this feels. Oh.
They're Dementium games on DS. They always pitch them first to be Silent Hill games for the DS.
Those games are way better than the fucking...
Book of Memories.
Yeah.
And every time Konami said, no, you're not good enough.
We're going to give it to Vatra.
Vatra. Who a developer no one's ever heard of.
You know, it's really sad because, like, if Downpour and Homecoming were, like, no-name, generic, like, unique IP horror games, you would laud them for being, like, good attempts.
Yeah, yeah.
But instead, they're massive failures.
If you mixed most of the enemies from Silent Hill Homecoming into Downpour, I would have liked Downpour a lot more. Because, like, I hated every single one of Downpour's enemies.
You mean all four of them?
Yes. All four.
Fuck, that totally got me. That
it was the bird. Did you see that?
Yeah. Totally got me. Good job.
And never touch a salad. That's a very scary thing for an enemy to say.
This
never
is
touch a salad, then I'll trust you.
This is a big meat-eating enemy.
Yeah. He loves big meat. Oh, well, they're truckers or, like, woodsmen.
Oh, this is a good part. Because this is the part that you're like, eat shit, motherfuckers.
We enjoy the magnificent woods. Kablauzos!
They get wrecked so fucking hard.
They hate Duracell branded flare guns too.
It's just so good, and I think
this is the first.
Yeah,
Night
I think
Springs.
We're coming up to Night Springs. Yeah.
We definitely need to watch this.
Yes. Get in here. Yeah, there
yeah,
it is.
Yeah. Pick up goodies first, though.
Yeah, very good goodies. Lithium.
Item limit.
It is Energizer.
Yeah. Oh, it is.
You kept saying Duracell over and over.
I thought it was weird.
That's weird. Brands.
Yeah. Brand confusion even.
Science. It bestows immortality on those who advance it to elevate all of mankind.
The actor they got for this bit is
amazing.
The best.
Nails
it's
it.
Perfect.
But the price was Carl Sagan was so smart, how come he's dead?
All three of those guys are dead.
There's been disputed evidence.
Yeah? About which one?
The first two.
Yeah? So, yeah, Sir Isaac Newton's walking around? So I'm really happy because I completely forget this.
I do too. Barclay Colvin is about to demonstrate that very courage.
Ladies and gentlemen of the press, I am Dr. Barclay Colvin.
Oh, it's so shitty. Oh my god.
Many of you could join me here at the Moorcock Institute.
I need Moorcock. I'm going to
give a practical. That's fucking juvenile.
Yeah, as it's written though.
You have to do it with an accent that would appreciate it. Oh, I need more cook.
That black guy's like, oh shit, I better get out of here. Known as a quantum
suicide. Did he say suicide? In the zoom in. He's kidding, right? Please, please. This is just Schrodinger's cat with a gun, right?
Kind of. No risk. Observe what occurs when I place
the weapon against my own forehead. Now, you might think this round is merely a dud. Not so.
Observe the flower. Alan's like, I could save my wife. And yet,
I myself. Oh, this is the stupid experiment where he, like, fixes its quantum state.
Yep. Two new realities bridge. It's quantum break.
A machine that could do this would be the most broken technology in the history of anything.
Yeah.
How does Kim Crimson work? Quantum
immortality. No one knows for sure.
Somebody linked me on the best friends Reddit to a link of a guy just screaming his ass off for like nearly 3 minutes, just screaming, "How does King Crimson work? Someone tell me how it works." Cracks me the fuck up.
Could happen at any moment, and they always do happen somewhere.
Did
not happen here.
You're insane, Colvin. Insane? Hey, was this thing supposed to be plugged in? I stumbled on it.
You fools. Gaze.
I was like...
Quantum immortality.
Like, I,
poor
so
Dr.
like,
Colvin.
The noise they
failed use, by his own hubris,
the noise they use for the gunshot is like them pouring out a bucket of chum.
Yeah, yeah.
Like, it's like all of his organs exploded out the side of his head. It's so ridiculous.
Well, you know, if you're smart, it's where you keep most of them.
I'm not gonna pick that up.
Yeah, it's fine. So it reminds me a lot of like just a slightly upgraded version of when you watch the TV shows in Max Payne. It would just be like 4 or 5 images that would just go into a slideshow and just with the voiceovers over. And that what we just watched is like slightly better. Like it didn't quite match up with people were saying. They're like 2 seconds off. It's hilarious.
Hey, Stucky. What up? You know what? I'm not gonna save this. Eat shit, fuckers.
Yeah, why not? Just go nuts.
Yeah, just go nuts.
Like, who's gonna stop you, the fucking...
Oh, I remember... I forgot about that. Where he just has crazy, like, Highway Star Stand powers.
Again, do you think, though, like, it's a lot like the fucking speed boost, like, dash ability in Quantum Break? It looks exactly like
that.
Yeah,
it does. You're super right. Oh, you hit him so hard. Feels so good.
Yeah, if I recall, Stucky takes a while to beat just because he's
tough.
Not so much he's tough, he just spends a lot of time just zooming around and running away.
I'm zooming around. I'm Carl Stucky. Where you at, Mr. Stucco? I remember that, like, I don't know how they did this, but the analog controls in this game are really specific.
They look like it.
They're really, like, rock solid, super good. Okay, Mr. Stuck. You know, I'm just gonna try and reach the gas station. I'm just gonna... Oh, no, wait.
It's all locked.
I can't
get... It's locked until Stucky is confirmed dead.
Damn you, Stucky.
He's so fast.
Damn you. Look at him go. Look at that Stucker.
You go, Stucky. You'll show them all one day. Fuck you.
You hit him with two of those, and he's like, "Oh, I'm a badass."
Like, I don't know why. He's just a boss, Stucky. I don't know.
Eat shit.
Fuck you.
That explosion effect was so fucking good.
Stucky's body vanished, leaving behind only a lifetime
of nightmares to come.
Assuming I'd reached the lights at the gas station alive.
Yeah, good.
And run, Mr. Weak. Run.
Wait, who's talking?
I am.
There you go.
Those deer are horrific.
It's a scary thing. Such erotic creatures. But,
What?
Yeah.
Hmm?
So...
What?
I really like, if only I could reach the gas station. I'm at the gas station.
It's like 30 feet away.
The gas station felt comforting. At least for a moment. The sane world reassembled.
I think this is where it happens, maybe.
Where what happens?
The chainsaw thing? No, wait,
no,
I think
no, that's way later.
Right.
Outside, there's only darkness. Outside the cabin, outside the story, there's only darkness. I can feel her presence in the dark. Just now, I could smell her perfume.
That actor's like, are you really sure I should wear this stupid tweed jacket?
No, no, it's important.
Okay.
It's really important that you wear the shitty tweed jacket.
I think in here you can read like a lot of fun things about the town, like little there's a good
little stuff on the walls. It's like Deerfest is the shit.
If you wind up really drunk on Deerfest, just make sure to pass out of the vision of any of the travelers. You don't want to give this town a bad name. You don't want to give this name a bad town. Hey, every single woman has short hair and a little bun.
It's that era, man. Thank God.
Fuck that era.
Sheriff yeah. Sarah Brake.
Dead or alive.
You know what I actually really like about like the sheriff? I like that like the cops are like, what are you fucking talking about? Everything you're saying is stupid.
Yeah.
But that makes sense because their cop cars might as well be beacons of invincibility.
Yeah. So they'll never see this shit.
Look at that.
Yeah.
The darkness is gonna come at you with that shit.
You know what's a real trope is like if you're a guy or a lady on a crazy adventure, and if you're about to call the cops or get some help, if you notice you have a head wound, fucking clean that shit up.
Hide it.
The first thing they'll say is like, seems like you knocked your head around there.
One of the things that you see pretty rarely, but it's like when someone's like, okay, gonna call the cops. Wait, no, that's stupid. What are the cops? Like, they're never... Like, that happens a couple times in JoJo where somebody's like, call the cops, and they're like, what are you, stupid? What are the fucking cops gonna do against stand users?
Yeah, shoot them. You know who can handle that? Whole horse.
Steely Dan, owner of the weakest stand in the universe, could destroy a million cops.
What? Okay, to be fair, but he could say, well, why is there a little path that's going into the water there?
Oh, yeah, it was a weird one. Yeah, we never checked that out.
I forget what song it was, but one of the chapter ends of this game, I was like, oh, this song's so good, and I did, like, look it up.
Yeah, here's where you cut out the audio so that a bunch of bullshit doesn't trip on YouTube.
Hey, well, Quantum Break has that thing that saves you.
Luckily, Quantum Break. So that's episode one of Alan Wake. Ooh. This game's great. You can probably pick it up for like a dollar now.
Probably.
Yeah.
But, you know, I think we've... It's unlike RE4 where it's like you can... Like, you... How many new things did you learn playing RE4 again? You found
every time
where you're like, Alan Wake is not one of those.
RE4, when we did the LP, I think that was my ninth trip through, and I was still finding new shit.
Yeah. But Alan Wake, as much as I like it, I don't think we'll ever do an LP of it.
There's a lot of forest.
There's a lot of forest, and there's
a part, like, two-thirds in the game, I think I mentioned earlier, where you're climbing a mountain, where it's like an hour and a half of just walking through the forest shooting guys. With nothing.
With nothing going on, yeah.
You climb up the mountain, you climb down the mountain, then you go through a water treatment plant.
Oh, God, the water treatment plant. Anyway, Alan Wake, there you go.
Good game.